You didn't do it yet?
Good morning, Passion Church. Hallelujah. It's so good to be in the house of God with the people of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There's no better place to be on the face of the earth than with the family of God. Hallelujah. Been looking forward to this Sunday all week. Praise God. Praise God. It's so good to have everyone out on social media. Join us this morning. We thank you for joining with us this morning. We're going to praise the Lord this morning, stand at your feet. Hallelujah. I'm so glad I know that there is no one like our God. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
With Jesus. Every day of the week I fall in love with Him.
Keep peace in your church, keep peace at work, have the love of Jesus. Because see, when we get so full of the love of God,
praise the Lord,
that look, even in the natural, families don't always agree on everything, but you're still family. In the church, everybody may not agree, but we can agree that Jesus died on the cross. Jesus came to save your soul. Jesus came as healer, deliverer, restorer, my everything. And Jesus came so that we could have people for our life. That's the main goal out there, is to be the light for those that do not know the light, that those that do not know what you know. This love that I'm talking about, the love that we just sang about.
Thank you, Father.
Keep that love. Saturate yourself in the love of God. I think it would do us all good to start looking up scriptures and reading about the love of God. Immersing yourself so deeply in the love of God that when everything else comes at you, you say, but God loves me, I love him, and I love those around me by the love of God. Oh God, I thank you, God, today for your love saturating us, your love overflowing around us and in us. Oh God, let it overflow out of us like never before to bring people into the kingdom. Oh God, let our lives tell the story of your love and your goodness and your mercy and grace. In the precious name of Jesus, amen. Well, I'm Pastor Sandy. And we're going to give you an opportunity to give now. Our ushers are going to serve you in the house. If you haven't been served, just raise your hand. They will give you an envelope. If you're watching live, or you're, maybe you'll be listening later on the podcast or watching on the YouTube and you'd like to give, you can go to mypassion.church, click on the Alex City campus, and there's an option there that says giving. It is safe and secure. You can also, there's ways to give by text. That information is on there. You can go to Facebook to get our address, or if you'd like to know the hours, Monday through Thursday, you can come by the church office and give your tithes and offering. You can mail it. There's many ways to give to God and for it to stay safe. Amen. I want to tell you something. Stay in the love of God and stay in the giving of God. Don't give back up on your giving. You say, well, I haven't been coming to church, but you need to not stop giving. Okay, God has a way, listen, when there seems to be no way, but you've got to stay in his way. Keep your time, your finances, and your prayer mixed all up in God real good. Amen? So, Father, we just thank you, God, today for your giving. People, we thank you, God, for those that are tithers and sowers, seed sowers. Father, we thank you for your faithfulness. We thank you, God, for missions, God, for the opportunity to give here locally and to the nations of the world. Oh, God, let our seeds go into the ground. God, let them come forth. Father, I thank you right now that this is a house that gives. Even there's people that are watching. You may say, well, I don't have a church home. Well, if you're being fed and ministered, sow into God's house and watch what he'll do. I thank you that every need is met. I thank you that there is no lack spiritually, physically, or financially. I thank you for raises and promotions and increase and change of jobs, doors opening for schooling and education and whatever needs are met, all the way down from elementary school, middle school, high school, and college. I thank you, God, that you direct their steps and make a way, and favor chases them down. Favor shows up everywhere we go in the precious name of Jesus. And if you could agree with that, say amen. Praise God.
Oh, great day, everyone. Good to see you all in the house of God, also to be coming to you via this wonderful, great thing, social media and the internet. Boy, the world is such a big place, but God has made it accessible and available to us and brought it down to where even the little can affect a great, great, little stone can affect a great, great ripple in the world today. We're thankful, so thankful for that. So grateful to God. I want to tell you something that I heard this week. It was about as strong as I've ever heard the Lord say anything. And he said, you need to tell folks this. I want to tell you how happiness happens and some news that you can use if you choose where your finances are concerned. You know, a lot of unrest, unhappiness, unsettledness in the economy. But I must tell you that there is a difference. There are two different systems. There's God's way that is under the blessing of the blessor, which is God. His authority and his ability. There's also the world's way, which the Bible's very plain about it. It says is under the curse because it's under the authority and the ability of the curser. The devourer, the robber, the thief, whatever you'd like to call him. But there are two different systems. You know, it's been prophesied in this house that there is a difference. It's different now. And we need to pay attention to those things. So here's what the Lord told me. That, again, about as strong as I've ever heard anything in my life. And he said, tell folks, if you tithe, I can help you. If you won't tithe, I cannot help you. Now, it's not that God doesn't want to help you or that he won't help you. It's simply that when we tithe, we bring ourselves, we position ourselves under the blessing of the blessor, his authority to use his ability to help us. If we won't tithe, and don't comes always out of won't, it's an act of the will, it's a choice. Which is good news, because if you need it to change, you can change it. It's yours to change. And God said, prove me, test me. Do this and see what I do. That's about the only place that we're allowed to put God to a test. Well, remember, if you won't tithe, remember, we position ourselves by choice, a disobedience under to the word of God, which causes a disconnect from the work of God, the will of God, and the work of God. As we're placed, now all you need to know about this, and be a Christian here, be a God seeker. And how we find God is in his words in Malachi, the third chapter. He said this. He goes, you are under the curse. He didn't say you were cursed. He said, you're under that curse. You're under the authority and the ability of the curser when you don't tithe.
That's right.
You're robbing me of my authority and my ability to bless you and to help you.
Amen.
And then all you need to know, you can find out all that you need to know to make your own decision. I'm not here to, you know, put pressure on you one way or the other. We're here to prepare you, the Bible says, for works, work of the ministry. And you're going to need financials to help God in his work. Amen. We honor God. We glorify God with our wealth. We want to be wealthy spiritually, and we also want to be wealthy financially. Amen. Now, listen, in this world, don't limit God to you being your source, your own source. Tithing makes God your source. Or the devourer your source. See? So there's a choice. I want to present to you also opportunity. There are so many people that depend on this broadcast, on us live streaming. And we're at a $3,000 project to upgrade. Now, we've upgraded today. Those of you that are listening should notice a definite difference, especially in the sound. We might look a little bit different. I'm not sure if clear is better all the time when you get to be my age. But anyway, I believe that God deserves and desires excellence. Amen. And that we should always be working to improve.
Amen.
Not with toys, but with tools. And this is an upgrade to a tool specifically for live streaming purposes, the equipment, camera, and such to upgrade the quality of our live streaming. That is the first step. Then there'll be other things that are that will afford us also by way of getting the word out. So we need to raise $2,000 more. We're at 1,000, which is good because we didn't start till late last year. You know, this is one of those things where we fell in the swimming pool, found out it's deep water, just had to learn to swim. And but here we are, and all is well. God's at work. Now, if your heart stirs you over this, it's an opportunity for an investment to advance the kingdom of God. Very, very practical way. You will be advantaged by God to advance with God. So if your heart stirs you, that's between him and you. But I pray for the release of that seed that he will provide. It will be found in a harvest of his supernatural supply in your life. That seed will come in a harvest for you. Whatever measure you choose to give him, some, none, some, or all, it doesn't, you know, that's up to you. But if your heart stirs you, say, you know what, Lord, if you will, I will, then expect, I'll tell you, God's going to bring some extra into you that you can sow a seed. And boy, I'll tell you, it just starts perpetuating from there. You'll never outgive or outdo God. Well, let's look at some things here today in the scriptures. And we're going to go to 1 Corinthians, the 13th chapter. You know, we're in this 21 days of fasting and prayer. We set the first at the first. We set ourselves to understand what God is doing. And I like this verse of scripture because it's written to us very personally. It says, you know, my understanding is incomplete now, but one day I will understand everything just as everything about me has been fully understood. And if you find yourself in a place of wondering and say, well, you know, there's some stuff that's just hard to understand. God, I don't understand why you don't this and you don't that. And God, I don't understand why they this or they that. And I don't understand, you know. But I also need to understand, as I am understood, God says, I know you don't understand. And there's some stuff that one day you will understand. And understand. We pray for understanding. We fast for understanding. The Bible says that the Spirit of God is given to us to help enlighten our understanding and show us what God, who God is, what God does, and what God has for all of us. And I do know this. I have enough understanding along this line that I need to hear from God. And I heard the Lord say this. I know that you know, some people are reticent to say that, but boy, you know, Jesus said, you got to be looking and listening every day for the word for the day. That's in Proverbs 8 chapter. A New Testament witness of this, he said this. He goes, you should just don't live a natural life. Just weren't thinking about, you know, what you're going to have for lunch. Remember what you had for breakfast. Looking forward to supper. He said, you need to live by every word. Listen, that streams out of the mouth of God. A stream is a continual flow. So I don't mind saying, I heard the Lord say. I'm looking and listening for the Lord. And if you look and listen for him, he'll speak to you. God speaks. He has spoken, but, you know, he still speaks out of what he has spoken. And I heard the Lord say, while we were worshiping, such a wonderful way that the Lord puts things together by the Holy Ghost. You'll see everything tied together so wonderfully today. The love of God, the hope of God, faith in God, trusting God. But Lord, we are commanded to pray for the community that we live in. We're commanded to pray for those in government, those in the church. We're commanded to pray for one another, that your kingdom and your will would be done. And I pray for the work of the Holy Spirit in hearts and lives, and that the ministry of reconciliation would be loosed. For you said, whatever we loose on this earth, it's all.